Welcome to the Tojo podcast on this fine Thursday. No, I'm not Australian and I'm not in Australia. I just thought it'd be a bit funny, you know, just to open up on a new accent. I do wish I was in the sun though, but no. Sunny Margate today on this Thursday podcast where I am sharing about whether you're going to be naughty or nice this Christmas, how to stay on track, some top tips, how to not blow the diet during this Christmas time. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're like, I just want a treat. It's just Christmas. You know, we all love a mince pie. We all love like that chocolate gâteau or that Christmas cake. And those are okay in moderation. So I'm going to go through 7 top tips today, this Christmas time, just to stop the, the bit of the Christmas belly developing and the sugar addiction kind of hitting and taking over again. So how do we stay on the nice list, on the good list this Christmas? Number one, Christmas Day, it's one day of feasting. Now, one day, Christmas Day. Now, I know we actually spread our Christmases out where we see this family and that family and this family. And we end up having like that Christmas Day meal like 3 or 4 times in a row over Christmas with all the crispy parsnips and the pigs in blankets and the stuffing bowls and the carrots and the turkey or whatever you have at Christmas time. We end up actually having that time and time and time and time again. Now, have you having it at Christmas for one day is not going to ruin your diet. Enjoy it. Enjoy that Christmas meal. You know, we've been through a bit of a rubbish year this year, so we're going to want to have that family time we haven't seen, and we're going to be let out of our cages for about 5 to 6 days. Enjoy that Christmas meal. But here's the thing, is if it goes over about 3 to 4 days, 2 to 3 days even, that's where you're going to actually start noticing the differences on the scales. So enjoy Christmas Day, or whatever day you allocate to be Christmas Day as a family. Enjoy that stuffing ball. Enjoy those parsnips. Enjoy those carrots or cabbage or cauliflower cheese or whatever you're gonna have. My mouth is watering right now. But enjoy it. But it's the making sure that we keep that as obviously like your cheat meal or your treat meal. And just making sure that you're just kind of like being very mindful of how far you've come. And just making sure that we don't actually overstep those boundaries, and we find that, you know, our jeans are far too tight and we need to adjust the belt as we sit around the Christmas table. So that's number one, keep it to Christmas Day as much as you can and just enjoy that time. Number two, if you are going to someone else's house, prepare your own healthy dish to take. So sometimes we don't have a lot of control over what people cook for us. We don't know how much butter or how much fat they're cooking the roast potatoes in. We don't know whether they're using goose fat or what the one cow spray. You have no idea. And sometimes you have very little control over that. But if you're able to take your own healthy dish, you know there's going to be a dish at the table that you are going to be able to actually dive into probably a bit more than what anyone else can. So for example, if you like Brussels sprouts, you can perhaps cook up some Brussels sprouts in the pan with a little bit of one cow spray, probably just like cut up a little bit of bacon bits in there as well, just to give them like a little bit of a flavor. Or if there's any other dish that you want to take that you know is healthy, that's going to help you stay on track, that's actually going to fill you up, then take that healthy dish along with you. Number three, here it is, don't overpile your plate. So you will see on your plate the pattern there. So your plate's either white or it's patterned. And here's what, you don't want to like totally eradicate seeing the bottom of your plate. So I know all you feeders out there, if you've got feeders in your family, whether it's like your mum or your nan, Or there's always that family member's like, would you like another roast potato? You look like you haven't been eating lately. I'm going to stuff you up on roast potatoes and parsnips and all the other carbohydrates, which we love at Christmas time. And what ends up is that we end up having this mountain of food. Now, if you're able to almost like split your plate into quarters and then a half, so ideally you'd be looking for a quarter of your plate of protein, a quarter of your plate of carbohydrates, and the rest in vegetables. Now let's kind of get this straight on the root veg front. Parsnips are carbs, so just be careful on the old parsnips. So if you can have as many vegetables as you want really on that plate, so that's carrots, cabbage, all your greenery, your Brussels sprouts are really, really good for you this time of year. Please don't drench them in butter. But Brussels sprouts are really, really good for you this time of year. But if you have, if you can see the bottom of your plate, and it's not kind of got this like Christmas meal mounting going on, then you're on your way into getting a bit of portion control. And portion control is so, so important. You know, when it comes to actually having that discipline in what you eat. So when someone brings in like your plate and you got like your turkey on it or your lamb or your pork, etc., just kind of like, you know, you don't have to eat the entire lot. I know some of us were trained from a child that you can't have dessert until you've eaten all your dinner, or you can't leave the table until you've eaten everything on your plate. And here's the thing is that unfortunately we did end up in the mess that we are today because we did obey those rules. So feel free, my friends, to disobey the rules this Christmas. You have full permission from Tojo to disobey those table rules. Just be careful on the carbohydrates. Don't overdo it on the roast potatoes. It might be that because you've been good all year round, you get to that into the carbs and you're like, I am absolutely stuffed because your body has become used to having like lower carbohydrates. And that would kind of be like the ideal thing. So just being cautious, don't overpile that plate. Make sure you can still see the bottom of the plate and that you don't feel you need to get your backpack to actually climb up the mountain of food. Number four, drink loads of water. Water actually quenches your hunger. So there are times through Christmas time, because you're not at work, you're gonna want a snack. Have a bit of water instead of snacking. Now, if you're saying to yourself, water is so boring, I can't just do water, try some fizzy water. Fizzy water makes you feel like you've got the fizz of a sugar drink without the sugar hit. Also, have water before you eat. So we all know if we guzzle down loads of food before we have our meal, we're actually quite full already by the time we get to our food. So drinking loads of water in between times, which is going to lead me on to the snack part next, is going to help you in your kind of wanting to stay on the wagon without falling off the wagon, playing drunk and falling under the wheels. Do stick to water. Don't say, oh, if it's fluid, I'm going to drink alcohol. Enjoy a bit of glass of wine. Don't get me wrong. Enjoy your G&T. But don't kind of like substitute it for good old fashioned H2O. Number five, limit extra calories. Limit the extra calories. Like I say, you are at work, and during work times, especially if you're a teacher, you don't have time to snacky, snacky, snacky. You actually stay on track, and because of that, it's easier to manage your weight loss. Now, you're not going to be in your usual routine. You're going to be at home. And what happens is when you come out of routine, oh, the snack attack starts. You start opening the cupboard that has got all the biscuits in it, that has got the cake, that's got All the little treats that someone's bought you for Christmas, all the quality street, the celebrations, the yard-long Jaffa cakes, which are being sold in the shop right now. And what happens is that you're like, oh, well, you know, I'm just hungry. Now, what we want to do is stick to the same food routine that you would do when you're at work. So make sure you still have your protein shakes in your snack time. So morning snack, protein shake, afternoon snack, protein shake. That will stop you, that'll actually fill you up, and that will stop you from having those little snacks. Because you know, we start to kind of look at the KP peanuts that are all packaged beautifully in the supermarket, and you're like, that would do so well for a snack whilst I'm watching a Christmas movie. Try and avoid things drenched in butter. So we're limiting extra calories here. Roast potatoes can be drenched in butter. Brussels sprouts can be drenched in butter. I think pretty much most of our Christmas dinner can actually be safely say it's drenched in butter. And butter is one of the most calorific, high fat foods that we can actually incorporate into our diet. There are other substitutes that we can have that you can, you've got little life hacks that you can get around when you're actually cooking up your veg, but just try and limit those. Also, some of your sauces can be quite calorific. So just have a check on your cranberry sauce, have a check on your gravy, how much is actually in gravy as well, because they can actually really stack up those calories. Whilst we want to enjoy that day, we also are aware of if we go way overboard, it may be hard to kind of like pull ourselves backwards on that. Number six, eat slow and enjoy your food. So I don't know about you, but depends what mood I'm in actually. I can be a slow eater, but if I'm really, really hungry, I can speed eat like the best of them. And what happens when you speed eat is that your body doesn't have the appropriate amount of time to actually process the food that you're putting in your mouth. And so the hormone or the chemical, as it sorry, not a hormone, chemical that tells you that you are full is so time delayed because it hasn't had the chance to actually process everything you've put into your mouth, and so it tells you too late that you're full. So to eat slowly, slow eater gets fuller quicker. So kind of like, you know, put a mouthful in, chew it, don't swallow it whole. Chew your mouthful and then take a breather, take a bit of water, take a drink, take a breath, and then have another mouthful. And you'll actually find that the slower you eat, you actually won't be able to get through your food, the whole lot from the plate, if you do have Everest, which has been piled onto your plate by your feeder and your family, you may not be able to get through it all. So just slow down your eating, give your body time to process the food. As you put it in your mouth, as soon as you start chewing, all the chemicals will start flowing and start breaking down the food, goes down into your body, and then your body is able to probably tell you, hey mate, I think you really need to stop at this mouthful. You know, listen to the little angel on your shoulder that's like, hey, I'm really full. And sometimes you're like, no, I'm just gonna have this one more potato. But don't have that one more potato, because you're gonna find that your belly probably will expand, and then you can't move, and then you feel ill because you've eaten too much. So just ignore, you know, the little devil on the shoulder is like, just listen to the angel. Was like, I think you've had enough. Oh, exactly the same, by the way. Like, if I get to Christmas time and like my mother-in-law cooks the best roast potatoes, I don't know what she does, but they're all crispy on the outside and they're fluffy in the middle. And I think sometimes I've downed about 7 to 8 roast potatoes in one sitting. Yeah, that bad. And then she brings out like, oh, cream for dessert and Christmas pudding and mince pies and the Christmas cake that someone else has baked, and you're sitting there and you're like, I feel like I have food coming out of my eyeballs and my ears at this time, and now I need to sit and eat dessert because it looks really rude if I don't sit and eat dessert and have the Bailey's cream and the whipped cream. And oh, we've all been there. But it's okay to say no. It's all right to say no. I know sometimes you're probably not going to want to say no, but it's all for the greater good, my friends. Don't forget that. All for the greater good. And lastly, how to stay nice this Christmas rather than on the naughty list. All those carbohydrates that you have eaten. Now, bearing in mind, if you go back to our carbohydrate podcast, you will know that carbs are fuel. Carbs equal energy. And we know that the reason why we cut carbohydrates down in the evening is because too many carbs, it means we've got too much fuel in our body, and then we go to bed without using that fuel. So the carbohydrate processes, turns into fat overnight, and that's where we get our weight gain from. Now, all those carbohydrates that you have eaten in your Christmas meals actually can be turned into energy for a workout. So keep moving during Christmas. Go out for a nice long walk. Go out for a bike ride. Keep up your workouts, because what will happen is that during Christmas time, you'll be like, oh, I'm just going to give it a rest. And having a rest, sometimes it means it's a bit too hard to get back into where you were. And you notice that you don't move as well as you did. You notice that your flexibility's gone up the swanny. You notice that, you know, all the cardio stuff that you did, you're a bit more out of breath than what you would be before. Use the carbs to work out. So keep up your online programming. Keep coming to the gym with me. Keep up your Zoom with me. During Christmas time, not only will it help with regards to processing all the extra carbohydrates, all those extra calories that you've taken on board. But if you find yourself in a bit of a stressful situation, I don't know, you know, all of a sudden the family has been able to come together at Christmas time and you haven't seen each other for most of the year. Sometimes, you know, the stress levels start to rise. The environment isn't as peaceful as what you had it during lockdown. And so your cortisol starts firing, the stress hormone starts firing, and in itself, that is actually quite damaging to our body. So take the time to have your workout. Please don't stop. Number eight, I'm going to put this in as a bonus. I only told you at the start, number seven. But number eight, I think, is going to be really, really important to keep your mind and your spirit strong, as well as your body through Christmas time. Make sure you take time out for you. I know this time is, it's gonna be, we've got these 5 or 6, 7 days, 8 days, I think, where we're trying to fit in all these family members that want our attention. And like I say, in that, that's gonna create a bit more of a stressful environment, probably than what you've been used to. Now take time out to breathe. Make yourself a cup of tea. Go and sit down in your favorite chair. Watch out the window. Put your phone down. Disconnect from social media. Don't have to check Facebook just to check what someone's had for Christmas, or Instagram. Just put it all down, pick up your tea, and drink your tea. Enjoy your tea. Create yourself that sacred environment that you are able to disappear to. You can leave the kids for half an hour playing, put them with dad, whatever. Just disappear, or put them with mum if you're a guy listening to this. Just disappear, go and drink your tea. Be in the moment, enjoy the tea. Don't be anywhere else. Come back to your center. We find ourselves, perhaps we're fragmented all over the place. We're trying to remember who's got what present. Where am I supposed to be on this day? Have I put the turkey in? Is the meat gonna cook in time? Do I have enough roast potatoes for the entirety of the family? You're gonna operate a lot better if you give yourself breathing time. Just saying. So here's a roundup of the tips that I've given you today. Number one, Christmas Day, one day feast day. Keep it as your one day feast day. Try not to let it bleed over into the other days. Number two, if you're going around someone else's house, or if you're at your house, bonus, cook a healthy dish. Make sure you've got a healthy dish on the table. Number three, don't overpile your plate. Try and still see the white bits at the plate. Try and keep it to a quarter protein, quarter carbs. The rest are vegetables. Number four, drink loads of H2O, especially before you eat, because that means it'll just fill you up a little bit more. You may not want to eat everything on your plate. That'd be a bit of a bonus. Number five, limit the extra calories. Try not to snack if you're getting bored during the day, or if you want to watch a movie and movies equal snacks, you know, the massive big cinema bags that you get. Try and limit the snacks that you have, the sauces. Be mindful of how much butter you're using in your cooking. Number six, eat slow. Enjoy your food. Slow eaters get fuller quicker. Number seven, use all those carbohydrates that you have consumed and turn them into energy for a darn good workout. It should be the best workout of your life, because the amount of carbohydrates in your system is going to fuel you like the Duracell bunny. Number eight, take time out for yourself to breathe. Drink your tea and enjoy it. So this has been Tojo's top tips for staying in the nice list rather than the naughty list. Keep sending in your weigh-ins to us as well if you're in part of the Tojo tribe. We hope this has been helpful to you in preparation for your Christmas, so you're able to actually prepare your meals ahead of time, let your family know exactly how you're going to be doing it. Your family will be watching you because they know you've been on your weight loss during the year. But we hope this has been a helpful time to you, encouraging to you. Stay on the nice list this year. Have a fab Christmas.